Hello, this is Kevin with Bangard Inc. And today we're going to take a look at creating our first report with the Sage Interactive Custom Report Writer. So let's get started. So I'm going to start with going up to my menu here, and I'm going to look at reports. And in the report menu is my Interactive Custom Report Writer. This is the reports that are already built into the system and so forth. So in the overview, this is where we kind of, you know, edited an existing one and kind of looked at some of the basic screens that we're going to look at in, you know, these more detailed sessions. So in this case, I'm just going to go right up to add so we can create our new report. The most critical thing when you're creating a report is how are you going to get started? So it's going to be either a new report, or I could take an existing report to leave the original one alone and make some modifications to this new one. In this example, I want to do everything from scratch, so I want to just do a brand new report. The most critical thing on report writing is what silo of data are you going to be writing a report on? So is this going to be a report that has something to do with AP? Is it going to have something to do with AR? Is it going to do something to do with jobs? What is the main detail of the data? So if I click on this drop down here, I'll see the different options that I've got. I can see AP bills, my payments, AR information, cost codes, employees. What is a report going to drive on? What's the most detailed amount of data that I'm going to see in this report? So that's going to be one of the most critical pieces of proceeding when I create a new report, because that's going to be the data that I'm going to see to be able to select from. So in this example, I'm just going to do like a invoice list by job. This is going to relate mostly to AP bills. And what's my report name? Most of the time I'd recommend naming the report something like AP and whatever the name of it's going to be and so forth. So that way they can kind of group by module or where the what the report kind of has something to do with. In this example, I'm going to put mine to start with the number 0 because I want mine to show at the top of the list so I don't have to scroll through it when we find it and modify it for some of the future videos. And I don't really need to say basic because we'll come back and modify it a few times. So let's say it's going to be an open, let's see, AP invoice list by job. Down here at the bottom, I'm not going to get into too much of this at this point, but this is where I can kind of control the security of who's allowed to see the report and some of those relationships. In this case, I just want to get into the, you know, the initial building of it. So I'm going to go up to create the report. In the overview report, we kind of talked a little bit about these different tabs and what I would do under each one of them. Most of this one, we're going to really just focus on the refine. That's where a lot of the initial report writing starts. With the refine, I'll see whatever data set I had started with. So in my case, I started with the AP bills. So this is where I can kind of see whatever it's associated with. As I open it up, I'll get more detail into trying to find the data that I'm looking for. So with AP bill, your primary object is AP bill. Attributes are going to basically be fields that are from that primary object. So things that are from the AP bill directly versus a dimension might be other information that's still directly related to that AP bill, locations, jobs, you know, other things that might be, you know, dimensions that you've associated on their GL information. Measurements will be where we'll get into when we start looking for typically things that are like amounts, invoice amount, dollars paid, or maybe a retainage, you know, some of those type of things might be under amounts. And related objects will get us into a whole other list of information that relates to it. So if I was looking at, let's say, like this is an accounts payable invoice, I might get into AP account and be able to see different things off my AP record itself, or information that's associated with some GL information, or this will just kind of get me into more data that still relates to that information. over here is where we'll see the report as we're building it out. So as I add things, I double click on them from here, they drop over here, and I could start to see the report get built out. So let's take a look at dropping some stuff in there. So I'm going to go to my attributes. You can grab this scroll bar and kind of move things left to right so that way you can see the names, especially when I've already got, it kind of depends on what I think is more critical. When I don't have anything in this report, Matt, this is more critical because I'm going to be looking for stuff to get over to into here. Sometimes if I'm coming back to modify one where I've already got a lot of my report body in here where I want to see more here, then I might leave this a little bit shorter when I'm looking at it, but kind of depends on where I'm at in my report building. In this case, I really want to see them. As I grab this and try to move it, it won't let me go very wide with one swing. It only, I don't know what that is, let's call it a half inch or you know, almost an inch. But I can do it multiple times, so I can creep this over a little bit if I wanted to, or creep it back if I want to kind of get that to be able to see those descriptions is what I like. So that way I could kind of really see the full field and kind of the table of where that's coming from. And what did I say? I'm looking for vendor. So let's come on down to find a vendor. So here's my vendor. And like I said, I double click on it. And now this just changed to what you see is what you get in your report mat. So this is already kind of previewing that report to let me see what type of data might be in that field, which is critical here because there's a lot of fields in the software. So there's a lot of times that we'll pick things or I pick things and it's not really the field I think it is. So very, very handy to be able to see that information right away. Maybe it's not right. I want to make it go away. Maybe that is the right field I want. So it's just a real nice way of confirming that you're getting what you think you're getting. And let's continue on. Let's say I want the vendor name. Let's say maybe I want the invoice. So I'm going to come back out of here and look at my related things to the AP bill. And let's say I want the bill number. That's going to be my invoice number. There should be, maybe I want a, whoops, that was the date, I think. Or was it just that? Maybe I want the invoice date. So at this point, finding what you're looking for is probably the most complicated thing, you know, at this point. I'm just looking through, looking for different fields that I want, dropping them on here. I might actually go in here and maybe there's something that some of them might say the word drill that sometimes will let me drill down into different things when I'm going through there. This is also where I can go through there and pick just different things as I'm going, building this thing out to kind of come up with whatever I want this report to show. In this case, I've also just picked a few things because I want to talk about removing columns. So I've just kind of picked me a few garbage ones along the way, or ones that don't relate to what I'm really wanting to do here at the moment. And let's say I want some invoice amount, what's been paid. And you'll start to see as I get very wide here that it's kind of clipped me off to what I'm seeing. And I've got a whole bunch of screen space here that I really want to utilize. So when you're writing reports, probably one of the most common things that you'll want to do is come up to this properties and tell it we want to view it in kind of a content page. And I could put a number of rows if I want to kind of limit it a little bit, but basically that allows me to use more of my screen for those that have larger screens and whatever that little thing was that I saw a moment ago. So it's starting to take shape a little bit. It looks like I've missed my job and job name. Let's go back into job and job name. Few things going on. So all I've done so far is pick all the different columns that I want, and maybe a few other ones that I found out that maybe don't have the content that I want. So as I'm looking at here, I'm going to basically do just some navigating. As I highlight over this column, I see a little move symbol where I can grab it and move job first. Move my job description with it. So I could start to see a few things have happened already. It's actually started grouping some of this together because I don't see the job on every single line. It knows to show me the job once and then go on to the multiple vendors, or if I've got somebody like Barth Electric here where I've got multiple invoices for that particular vendor, it's kind of going through and just showing me headings for those without showing me that on every single line by default. By moving the columns is really just how you kind of set the order that you want the content to show. If I've got something in there that I just flat out do not want, I don't remember what it was. I think this drill one I put in there and maybe this description I didn't really want. If I go back to my define, I kind of see the same information. I just can't see it real time as far as the data itself. It's going to show me more vendor name, vendor, job, you know, whatever the different columns were that I had picked. This drill down was one that I didn't really want. So if I go ahead and click on the drop down there, I could say delete. The description, maybe I didn't really want at this point, so I could say delete. And if I move back to refine, that will go back and show me, there again, example, what this report looks like so far. So I could see I'm starting to take shape a little bit with the job associated with it, the vendor, the invoice numbers, the date of the invoice amount, what's been paid, context. There is the very first report. A great getting started on getting at what field you're going to use, getting or what table you're going to use for your data, and then picking the different fields that you want to see in your report. Up at the top is how you save a report. So this is a save versus save as. So I don't know why save as is difficult to see with how I've got my pointer magnified, but the save as is very handy when you're doing reports. I find myself liking to do save as where I can go back and look at an in, you know, prior version of the report before I come up with that masterpiece of what the report's final is going to look like. So I've been known to write reports, put a filter or condition on or something that took away data that I really needed to see that is handy to be able to go back to prior version sometimes and see what it looked like and so forth. So that's a very common button. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and just hit save. If I go back and look at my reports and my interactive reports writer, I should be able to find my new report on the list. There's my new one on the list. So because I put zero, I've made mine at the top of the list at the moment. If I go ahead and take a look at running it then, so this is where I can see my report name at the moment and whatever columns I taught the report to do. And that concludes the initial very basic report creation using the Sage Intacct Custom Report Writer. Thanks for watching.